Hello. Here we will discuss how a transistor is working as an amplifier. Now I know that a transistor has got many applications, and one of the important applications of a transistor is in the field of amplification. So let us first see what is meant by amplification. Amplification is basically the process of raising the strength of a weak signal without changing the overall shape of the signal. See, I have a signal like this. And if I amplify this and get a signal of this shape, I can say that I have amplified the signal faithfully, which means that both the positive and the negative half cycles are amplified equally. On the other hand, if I amplify this same signal and end up with an output of this shape, this is called unfaithful amplification, because only the positive half cycle is amplified according to our wish, and the negative half cycle is not at all amplified. In such a case, we will say that this has resulted in an unfaithful amplification. That is the first point to remember. Now the second thing is that a transistor is basically a device that transfers a signal across a resistor. The transistor is basically a device that transfers a signal across a resistor. You know that in every transistor circuit, the input circuit, here I have shown a common emitter mode of an NPN transistor going to work as an amplifier. So we have an NPN transistor connected in the common emitter mode working as an amplifier. Now here the input circuit, which is the base emitter junction, is properly forward biased, and output circuit is properly reverse biased. So in every transistor circuit, the input circuit is properly forward biased and the output circuit is properly reverse biased. Now when you forward bias a PN junction, and you may also remember that a transistor is nothing but two PN junctions connected back to back. The combination of two PN junctions connected back to back works as a, or it is, you can also interpret the transistor like this. You have connected two PN junctions back to back. So one of the PN junctions is forward biased and the other one is reverse biased. Clear? So when you forward bias a PN junction, naturally its resistance will decrease. On the other hand, when you reverse bias the junction, the resistance will increase. So what you are doing in a transistor is transferring a signal from a region of low resistance to a region of high resistance. And that is what the transistor does. The name of the transistor itself is transfer across a resistor. So this is another point which you should keep in mind. So I have told you what is meant by amplification and what is meant by transistor. Now let us see how does the transistor amplify. I have connected two batteries, DC sources, one at the input and one at the output. The duty of these two sources, DC sources, batteries, is to ensure that this one has a duty to see that the base emitter junction is always properly forward biased, and the duty of the other cell DC source is to see that the collector emitter junction is properly reverse biased. So these two cells make sure that the forward bias circuit, the input circuit and the output circuit are properly biased. One of them is forward biased and the other one is reverse biased, and that is what for we are using these two cells. Now this battery has a very important application, that it ensures the proper flow of zero signal collector current. What do we mean by zero signal collector current? Imagine that there is no battery here. Now if you apply only the signal at the input, what happens? During the positive half cycle of the applied signal, this base emitter junction will be properly forward biased and a current will flow through the load resistor. That happens during the positive half cycle of the input signal. Now what happens during the negative half cycle of the input signal? This base emitter junction will be reverse biased, and that will result in no current flowing through the load resistor. So we will not get an amplified output. Only one half cycle will be amplified, because during the next half cycle of the input cycle, the base emitter junction is reverse biased. Such a thing should not happen. Under all circumstances, under all conditions of the input signal, the base emitter junction should be properly forward biased, and for that purpose we are using this battery. This battery will ensure that during both the cycles, positive as well as negative, the base emitter junction is properly forward biased. During the positive half cycle, there will be more forward biasing, so more collector current will flow. During the negative half cycle, the forward biasing will be a little less, even though it will still remain forward biased, so the collector current will decrease. It doesn't matter. Whatever be the case, this battery will ensure that the base emitter junction is properly forward biased. Clear? Now, this battery is to see that, I told you a little earlier that this battery is used for ensuring that the collector emitter junction is properly reverse biased. So the first point to remember is that this cell is there to maintain a proper flow of zero signal collector current. That is the first thing. Now there are some other points which you should also remember. Then proper maintenance of the base emitter voltage. The base emitter voltage should also be properly maintained. You know that in a PN junction, the current will start to increase rapidly only when the depletion layer is destroyed. So this base emitter voltage should be such that it is above 0.5 volt for germanium and 0.7 volt for silicon. Because only when you reach those voltages, the depletion layer will be completely destroyed and the current will increase rapidly. So that is the second point, proper maintenance of the base emitter voltage, and also the proper maintenance of the collector emitter voltage. That is another point to remember, because the collector emitter junction should be properly reverse biased. Otherwise, the electrons which passes through the base and reaching the collector, the electrons in a transistor, the electrons which are emitted by the emitter pass through the base and reach the collector. And in the case of an NPN transistor, this is the block diagram of an NPN transistor. You can see that the majority carriers here in the base region are holes. Even though the base is doped moderately, there are a few holes present here. So the electrons which pass through the base to the collector, some of them will be lost in the base region due to the recombination with the holes. So that will constitute a current called base current, which is the unwanted current in the working of a transistor. Base is the most important part of a transistor, but the base current is not a wanted current, but a desirable current in the working of a transistor. That is why we dope the base lightly. So the base is lightly doped. So majority of the electron will reach the collector, and for them to reach the collector has to attract them, and that is why we have reverse bias the collector junction. So if the proper reverse biasing is not maintained here, the electrons will not be attracted by the collector. The collector will not be able to attract the electrons much, and as a result, majority of them will recombine with the holes in the base region, and the base current will increase, which is not a desirable effect. And that, so we have to keep in mind three things. Number one, proper flow of the zero signal collector current. Number two, proper maintenance of the base emitter forward biasing, and the proper maintenance of the collector emitter voltage. These are the things that you should remember. Now, how does the transistor amplify? See, you know that when I increase the base emitter voltage, the base current will increase, and the base current, when it increases, it will pass through the collector. The current that flows through the collector circuit or the load resistance, the collector current. So any small increase in the base current will result in an almost similar increase in the collector current. If you increase the base current by a small amount, and that can be done by increasing the input voltage. So if you increase the input voltage, the base current, the input current will increase, and there will be almost a similar increase in the collector current. So what happens is, the collector current, when passing through the load resistor who has a very high value, will cause a large potential difference across this load resistor, and that will give you a much higher output. I will give you one example. Suppose we have increased the base voltage by 0.1 volt. If I increase the base voltage by this base emitter voltage by 0.1 volt, input voltage is increased by 0.1 volt, which results in a base current, in an increase in the base current whose value is 2 milliampere. See, I have increased the input voltage by 0.1 volt and that resulted in an increase in the base current by 2 milliampere. Now this 2 milliampere will flow through the load resistor. Let us assume that the load resistor has a value which is 5 kilo ohm. Our load resistor has a value, say 5 kilo ohm. So when this 2 milliampere flows through the 5 kilo ohm resistor, a voltage drop of V equal to IR, this is equal to 2 into 2 milliampere into 5 kilo ohm. This will result in a voltage equal to 10 volt. So you will get an output voltage or an increase in the output voltage which is of 10 volt. See, you have increased the input voltage by a small amount of 0.1. And how much is the increase in the output voltage? 10 volt, or the increase is almost 100 times. So you have amplified the signal by 100 times. This is how the transistor amplifies. And this happens because the emitter current or the input current here is the base current. The base current, if any small changes in the base current will result in almost the same, or the any small changes in the base current, you can see that almost similar changes are happening in the collector current, and that current, changed collector current, is flowing through a resistor who has a very high value, which means that when you multiply this current, the collector current flowing through the load resistor, you will get a higher output. And that is what is essentially amplification means, raising the strength of a signal without changing the overall shape of the signal. Is it clear? Okay.